My name is Dr. Juliet Daniel, and I'm a molecular cell biologist in the Department of Biology at McMaster University in Hamilton, Ontario. I've been here at McMaster for approximately 18 years, and my lab has been studying the role of the transcription factor chiasso and its role in cell-to-cell adhesion, signal transduction, and cancer. So triple-negative breast cancer is a subtype of breast cancer. And it's unfortunately one of the most aggressive types of breast cancer, meaning that it spreads quite quickly and aggressively to vital organs such as the brains, the lung, and the liver. And it's also unfortunate because it's disproportionately most prevalent in Black women and Hispanic women, and consequently also has the highest mortality rate. The reason for this high mortality rate is because there are no specific treatments for triple-negative breast cancer. So breast cancers are typically classified or subclassified based on the expression of three biomarkers. These biomarkers are the estrogen receptor, the progesterone receptor, and the HER2 receptor. Tumors that express the estrogen receptor are typically treated with a drug called tamoxifen, while breast tumors that express the HER2 receptor can be treated with the drug known as Herceptin. However, the triple-negative breast cancer subtype of breast tumors lacks the expression of all three biomarkers. That is, they lack the expression of the estrogen receptor, the progesterone receptor, and the HER2 receptors. Consequently, they cannot be treated with tamoxifen or Herceptin, and the only real treatment, current treatments for triple-negative breast cancer are standard chemotherapy as well and or radiation therapy. And this is why the tumors tend to be so aggressive and have such a high mortality rate in patients, because there's not a lot of targeted therapies that will address and treat triple-negative breast tumors, which is why we're very passionate and focused on trying to determine what is causing this racial disparity in triple-negative incidence and outcomes in Black women. So if we can link chiasso definitively to this racial disparity in incidence and or outcomes in triple-negative breast cancers, that will help us to maybe develop chiasso, for example, as a prognostic tool to determine which women are most likely to develop triple-negative breast cancer, and or possibly to determine which women will have a poor outcome from triple-negative breast cancer based on the expression levels of chiasso in their in the tumor. So one of our long-term goals is to develop a prognostic or diagnostic kit where we can examine chiasso expression levels in women of the African diaspora, similar to what's done with the BRCA1 genetic test that's currently used, to see whether or not any women in the African diaspora with a family history of breast cancer have a higher risk of developing triple-negative breast cancer.